Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I render exposition of Luke 8:47-56. And when the woman saw that she was not hid, that means she had been spotted, she came trembling. She was frightened that he might be angry, you know, why I touched his clothes. And falling down, she humbled herself before him. She declared unto him before all the people for what cause she had touched him and how she was healed immediately. So the woman, you know, told the matters of her heart without any shame, without any fear, without any people be saying, hey, what the hell she is talking about. That means what she was inside, she wanted to be outside. So she was not a hypocrite. Only the hypocrite are what is inside and what is outside is different. So she had the faith, and when she had the faith, then she declared what inside, outside. And Christ Jesus was so pleased, and he said unto her, daughter, be of good comfort, thy faith hath made thee whole, go in peace. So that's how one should be. If one want to say prayer or other thing, one should be what is inside should be outside, no hypocrisy. While he yet spake, there cometh one from the ruler of the synagogue's house, saying to him, thy daughter is dead, trouble not the master. So the one of the men from the synagogues, his household person, came and told the ruler of the synagogue who had come to Christ Jesus for mercy, that don't bother him. But when Jesus heard it, he answered him saying, fear not, believe only, have trust in me, and she shall be made whole. She will be okay. So this man, he did not believe what his servant or what his messenger said, but he had faith in God Jesus, full faith, and like that woman. And when he came into the house, he was suffered no man to go in, save Peter, James, and John. Peter, James, and John, they are people of Trinity. Peter is once born, James, doubting type, and John, sealed to serve God, and the father and the mother of the maiden, of the parents of the girl. And all wept and bewailed her, but he said, weep not, she is not dead. Now, the people were wailing and other thing, but whatever comes out of the mouth of one blessed with the Holy Spirit, the very Spirit of God, is absolute truth. So Christ Jesus told them, she is not dead. That means it was absolute truth. And while people were speaking, was relative secular truth. As people say, you know, so many Jews died in the Holocaust. This is the secular truth, but it is not the gospel truth. Gospel truth is this, that if a Jew is one who is inwardly, is a title or is a spiritual self which was not born, and how can it die? It was not a single Jew died during the Holocaust. But people of different tribes, Levi tribe, Matthew, Benjamin, all those tribal people died. And they were led by the blind, leading the blind into the pit. Pits were Holocaust. But sleepeth, and they laughed him to scorn. The people who were there, they laughed, look, she is dead, and he's saying sleeping, that they did not believe in him. So those who did not believe in him, Christ Jesus did not allow them to come into the room, knowing that she was dead. Now they think it was she was dead. So that's why Christ Jesus didn't allow them to come into the room. Christ Jesus doesn't perform miracles before unbelievers. Only among the believers he performed the miracles. And he put them all out and took her by the hand and called, saying, "Maid, arise." So he put all the unbelievers out of the room and asked the girl to arise. And her spirit came again, and she arose straight away, and he commanded to give her meat. So he told the parents to give her something to eat, and her parents were astonished, but he charged them that they should not tell no man what was done. That means he told them, you know, that they should not tell other people that it was Christ Jesus did it, because Christ Jesus, without the power of our Father, could not do anything. So he wanted the glory to pass on to God and not to himself. So that's why he was saying, don't tell I did it. It is the God who did it. So let's glorify God and not the man. So whenever we preach a gospel, we should always seek the praises of our Father, who hath given us this Spirit, our Holy Spirit, to understand gospel. If he had not given us this Holy Spirit to understand gospel, how can we preach gospel? No way. So only when you have Spirit of God in you, which is Holy Spirit, which is common sense when used. When the common sense is misused, it is called evil spirit of Satan. As those people in the where the herd of swines were thrown into the lake, they had evil spirit. So they had fanatics who had evil spirit too. So they were drowned. So the Christ Jesus always performed miracles among the believers, and that's why when in Jerusalem it was full of the unbelievers who would mock him, who would laugh at him, and he did not perform any miracle among them, just told them and gave them the story of the prophet Jonah. Oh, he was in the stomach of the fish for 3 days alive, and then he came out. So he did not perform any miracles, only in the villages are those people who believed in him. Those people who have no faith in him or no faith in God, they were not honored with these miracles. So the people who touched him, they were not arrogant, they were humble. So only humble people can have the mercy of God. Those who are arrogant and those who are self-centered, they do not enjoy the mercy of God. They are arrogant, you know, they are buffeted with their own ego. So when ego is there, it is the enemy of spirit. So those people who are having a egoistic, arrogant, you know, like the Pharisee and Sadducee of Jerusalem, they were arrogant, they have read so many books, they know this and that, but they don't know that in spirit, it is the common sense that counts, not the book knowledge. That's why Christ Jesus said, "Letter killeth, Spirit giveth life." Without Spirit, you cannot make the letter alive. Now Christ Jesus, when he was preaching in synagogues and other things, through Spirit he was making scriptures alive. And that's why he was preaching them with authority, that the people were surprised to hear the exposition of the moral laws. So God bless you, and hope you enjoy my videos. Thank you very much. Bye.